when I was an adolescent, I didn't like Beethoven. I thought he was loud and vulgar. Then I heard Serkin's recording of the Diabelli, and I fell in love with the music. I fell in love with the performance. And I was coming to London to study with Myra Hess. Third period Beethoven was the only thing that interested me in my modest years of being 20. The late quartets I listened, late sonatas, and there were few musicians who understood. I mean, they played it quite differently. Myra Hess, Schnabel, Bachhaus, completely differently. But they understood, you could hear it, that third period Beethoven is not like other period Beethoven. And I was absorbed by the music. I was completely crazy about it. I'd give up all the sonatas to play the Sibelius Violin Concerto or win Wimbledon, with the exception of Opus 109. I learned it and first played it when I was 18, and that I retained my love of this piece, this sense of wonder. And there's a tenderness there, as if it was possible, a divine gentleness there. Let's hope there is one, but it's certainly in the music. I think the D minor is one of the greatest things anybody ever wrote. And the greatest things are there before you've even played a note, the great Tutti. I know he's not as great as the other people, and yet I prefer him. He's not Mozart, he's not Beethoven, he's not Wagner, but I prefer the D minor to any of the other concertos of the so-called great people. If I would play the D minor Brahms again, it would be completely different than the one with Colin. I'm almost curious to hear it, to go to my own concert, to hear what it's like. My first concert with him was, well, I was obviously very young. The rehearsals were wonderful, the performance was wonderful. And for about 10 years, we did so much together. And I still would say I enjoyed him more than anybody I've ever worked with. He had a passion which I had a kinship with. When he's on fire, he's a great, great, great conductor. Well, there are four concertos with Colin, but I loved doing them with him, I remember. And he and I had a rapport with Mozart. That was quite genuine. I don't think I ever met a musician who felt Mozart more passionately than he did. But we were actually going to have another crack. But it, pity, real pity for me. It's a piece I'm passionate about. It's a kind of totem dance. And we performed it about 10 times, and then the recording is the best example of me. I'm very, very proud of that. I won't put my hands through that anymore. It's a savage piece. I'm not sure I could, and I won't anyway. I got it out of my system. It's rooted in dance. There's something chilling and remote and beautiful. And I think, you know, he was writing when the Second World War was going to happen or in the air, and all the horrors of it. And I think he sensed it, and maybe even experienced some of it. He has a sense of isolation, which is quite unique. We arrived at 7 o'clock at night and started to play the piano. Either my or her piano wouldn't play at all. And finally, the porters admitted they had dropped one of the pianos. So Vittorio Negri was the producer. At 8 o'clock at night, where do you find a D? And Steinway was closed. We just sat there, and Philip started ringing everybody in creation. A piano arrived at 2:30 in the morning, which is suits Marta fine. That's just when she's waking up. So we did the recording from 2:30 until 7, and it's very, very, very good. But I thought I was cooked. But in fact, you rise to the occasion. But that was funny. knew him when I was in my mid-20s, and I was at lunch with him and some friends, and he said, "Stephen, would you like a piano concerto?" Well, of course, he was very popular, very gifted, and known so at the time. Of course, I said yes. And I told him if I could stretch, and I said, "I don't want it at the last minute. I have to have it 6 months before the first performance." And the meticulous person that he was, he, well before 6 months. Piano has brilliant things, but the best music's in the orchestra. So I think that's why it hasn't caught on. It's also not easy. It's not impossible, but it's not easy. The Chopin, I played it for Marta about 2 years ago. I hadn't heard it in 20 years. Chopin, when I was adolescent, was my favorite composer. Chopin, Wagner, Scriabin. And I thought I would be a Chopin pianist. And when I first came to this country at parties, I really had the mazurka knack. And I learned 30 of them, and I'd play them at parties. And they really did have something. And when I hear the early Philips Chopin, it has something. Certainly the rhythms in the mazurkas are good. They seem to me authentic. Well, above all, Bartók II with Colin Davis. The recording is the best example of me. I'm very, very proud of that. And the Sonata for Two Piano and Percussion with Marta Agrish. And then Brahms II with Colin. Solo repertoire. Pieces not often played, the Opus 76 of Brahms. I think they're among his most amazing and adventurous pieces, and I'm very, very proud of that recording. Doesn't please everybody, but it pleases me.